P22. This is that guy 781 decided to come at you with a video reveal, and you can probably tell by the title, it's on the Walther P22. Let's go ahead and take this bad boy out of the box and get to it. This is how your pistol will come. And there's the box with the little Walther logo on it. It's kind of a plain box for, you know, such a distinguished company. But, you know, it is what it is. Alright, let's open it up. First of all, we're going to go over the contents of the box, what you will get. You will get a lock for safety purposes and to secure your weapon against children and all that. You should be aware about the act to make sure your gun is not accessible to young children. You should know about that law and act if you own a firearm. And also, being a responsible firearm owner, you should always secure your weapons. Also, we have a few accessories. All right. We have a, now I'm gonna explain that, I don't know what some of these things are, and I'll explain that later. All right, first we have what looks like the takedown key there. We also have a wrench. We also have three different front sights, and we also have this pin here, which I'm not quite sure what that's for yet. And we'll explain why I'm not sure what that's for yet in a second. We also have one additional back strap, in case you want to change the back strapping of the firearm. And then, of course, we have the firearm itself. Now, this gun is going to be unloaded. We're going to safety check it now. Clearly nothing in there, nothing in the magazine. So you want to dry fire that, get that, we'll decock it, get everything out of so we can rest that hammer. All right, a couple things you don't see is the registration card. I already filled that out, but I ended up registering the gun online, which was a lot quicker. And the instructions. We took the gun to the range like that with all the stuff in the box, and I guess we must have lost the instructions at the range. So, I'm not going to do a takedown and disassembly and reassembly of the weapon because I don't have the instructions, and I haven't practiced with it, and that'll probably take 10 minutes on its own in a video. Alright, let's get over some of the specifications of the gun. It has a 10-round magazine. It is a shoots 22 long rifle. Barrel's about 3 inches long, gun weighs about 15 ounces. It's 1.1 inch wide. Let's see, it has the 3-dot adjustable sights. And one thing I'm really not a big fan of is the trigger so far. The single action trigger is 11 pounds. When I pulled the single, not the single action, but the double action trigger, when I pulled the double action trigger, it feels like I'm gonna break the gun because it's 11 pounds and the gun has a polymer frame. But the single action pull is about 5 pounds, which is actually like my personal standard for a combat weapons trigger pull overall, single action or double action. Also, let's go over some of the cool things that the gun has. Does have an accessory rail for you guys that like to attach lights, lasers, and all those doodads to it. The magazine is metal, so that does help. It also has the floor plate that I do like. It can, even for this one to be very small, me having larger hands, it does fit in my hands very well. It has serrations on the front of the slide and on the rear of the slide so that you can rack it from here or here. It does have ambidextrous safeties on both sides. I do like the 3-dot sights. They're actually very usable. And I like the fact that you can change out the front blade, and the manufacturer actually provides that in the box for you. Does have an exposed hammer, so you can choose to cock the weapon. If you choose not to use a double action pull for your first shot, you can cock it and use a single action pull. Now, another thing that's a bit different about this gun, as opposed to other guns, it does have a different mag release. Now, the mag release, as most people are used to, is going to be about here, and it's going to be the 1911 style mag release. This one actually has it here, which is actually the H&K style. Now, while it does have that H&K style magazine release, I assure you it's not that hard to get used to. And this gun actually does a really good job of spitting out the magazine. Just look at this. I'm going to hold the gun parallel. Look at that. I'm holding the gun completely flat. Oops, doesn't go that way. Holding the gun completely flat, and it just spits out that mag. And I think that's a great thing in case, you know, you're in a situation where Walther P22 is all you had and you have to do a quick effective reload. That is a very good thing for a gun to completely spit out a magazine. Also, the magazine itself I enjoy a lot. I got this gun for my wife, and a few things that she doesn't, and I actually originally gotten her revolver, and she didn't like the kick of that, but she did like the simplicity of it for loading it and unloading it after it was fired. Now, I saw that, and you know, she really liked my Walther 20, I mean, not my Walther, my Ruger 22-45 and my Ruger Mark II for their ease of loading and the fact that they're just uber accurate guns, basically. But the Walther does have some good cues with the magazine, because it does have this little thumb plate here, which makes loading the magazine really easy. Although that is very easy, I'm not too big a fan of the price of the magazines. The magazines will run you like roughly, I believe it was like $34 at the gun store. You probably get them online for less, but I think that's still a lot to pay. This model is clearly the military OD green, olive drab, whatever color that is. Model. Now, a couple things I want to get on about the gun, and now this may be only true for my gun, or it may just be certain generations of Walther P22s, but mine, notice people are saying, you know, the guns are really finicky with which ammo that you use. So I actually used two brands, but three different varieties. And the first brand we used were 3-Mags from CCI. Functioned great, functioned flawlessly. But you know, CCI mini mags are, you know, a higher quality 22 in my opinion. We also tried the better, I guess you could say possibly defense related 22s, which would be the CCI Stingers, worked equally as well. Then something unprecedented happened. We tried to use a bulk pack of 22. Yes, right, I said it, a bulk pack. Now, most people don't, usually suggest bulk packs for semi-automatic handguns. Only guns that I have that don't really care are my three Rugers, the 10-22, the Mark II, and the 22-45. But everyone said the Walther P22 is super finicky. So I tried the Winchester bulk pack, the 333-round jacketed hollow point, and they shoot at 1,280 feet per second, which is actually just about the same speed as the Mini-Max. Worked great. Gun had out of, we shot about 400 rounds through the gun of all these types. No failure to feeds, no failure to ejects, nothing. So the gun just worked great. Only thing that I will complain about is that the sights were not dead on out of the box. But you know, you can hope for everything, but it's not gonna happen. The sights I actually shot, well not the sight, but the gun actually shot up and to the left quite a bit. If I aimed, like I actually shoot at a, I don't have one here, but I actually shoot at a target that's basically five, it's an 8.5, I print out my own targets. It's an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, so that was five circles on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I would aim at the one here and shoot and hit here, dead center. But when I did do that, my groupings were very tight. So I don't have anything negative to say about the reliability or the accuracy of the gun. I just got to adjust the sights, and I didn't bring anything to adjust the sights when I went there. Also, when I got this gun, it was through something this and the Sig Mosquito. The Sig Mosquito is running $269 at the gun show. I'm really happy I got this, because when I purchased this gun, the guy behind the gun counter, I told him I was going to get a Mosquito maybe also. And he was like, you know, be happy you didn't, because you got the Walther. Most people buy the Sig. And, come back and try to get the Walther. So I'm very happy I got this. Also, it wouldn't have been for me, because I needed one gun that'll fit my wife's hands, and that's the one she wanted. And it's an awesome gun. I recommend this gun to anyone who wants a nice 22 to practice with. That's almost like similar to a combat gun, as opposed to shooting like your Ruger Mark IIs or 22-45s. And I just think it's really an awesome gun. If 22 is actually only ammo you can afford, it's maybe a good defensive gun for you. Or, you know, this just may be a training tool or a defensive gun. I know most people wear 22 on a rifle hand, but you know what? It's better than a stick. And on that note, this is that guy 781 signing out. I wish I could say more, but I got a 10-minute limit, and I'm going to keep it short. So please subscribe for more gun reviews and blade reviews. Thanks for watching.